Gukubanga bizongo. Woo child, it's a Wednesday. And of course Wednesdays is the usual ish. We have to crush on a woman or two or whatever. I don't think I want to crush on any woman today, because if I dare do crush on the people that I feel I should be crushing on, are you following my drift here? I feel like it will come off as not a crush. It will come off as you know what? Does it even matter? My name is Tina Fierce One and welcome to Scoop and Scoop. Okay! But I'm trying to find where to start this whole thing from. So yesterday, Sheila Gashumba took a moment, a very, very long moment, and wrote an open letter to all her naysayers, haters, lovers, and just somewhat sayers. She took a moment, went on Facebook, and typed a very, very, very long, long, Jesus, long message. What did I tell you people? This is the same thing I told Dorothy Mwima. This is the same thing I told Haba Chonga's Shani. Now it is Sheila Gashumba. Because it is my job. Anyway, purpose of her very long open letter. Well, her open letter had nothing else but she was trying to put everybody in their position, talking about how she and her man, we should stop hating, we should stop saying all these weird things. There's nothing that that guy doesn't know about her, or that she doesn't know about the guy. Basically, she was trying to clarify of those things. Ngabi abakazi boku muzigo bebakola nzera, nzera, mkazi wagundi, omubwati, omubwati, tomanyira, nzo wange, mwaga basically obu yisa yisa. Na yogera bi ayogedde. She is not young. She is not 18. Why do people think like she doesn't? She doesn't know her age. She's of sound mind. She loves this man. Now I was reading this whole thing with a look on my face like, let me recap for you. Zari did the same shit. Oh well, we all know what happened. Banji, Zari did the same ish. Dorothy Shonga did the same ish before they broke up and broke up and came back and broke up and came back. Fia and Katz did the same ish. Manange, watch him work over balai in the Facebook relationships. What is your problem, people? I don't even know how I should come at this. I've been trying to find a way of how to come at this. First of all, I'd like to take a minute for all your Facebook in-laws. Ooh, child, wabado inabanji. Baba dewa, they were ready for that. But Sheila. In this day and age, you still feel you need the validation of the people. You need the validation of the people for you to carry on a good relationship without stress and everything. You still feel you need to come and fill us in. If we don't know what the two of you feel for each other, or how good it is or how bad it is, guess what? We don't know. But when you come out and you tell us, now we know, and then we're going to judge. But hey, you know what? Yesterday I was watching a series called Black Mirror, and it made me look at social media in a very different light. You need to go and watch that, Sheila. You need to. But don't put my handsome father in this. I was like, girl. Anyway, and then everybody started talking about the fact that, oh, her new man, she's a homewrecker, the guy had a wife and child. I mean, we knew he had a wife and child. I mean, clearly you knew, because you said it. You said there's nothing he knows about you that you don't know about him, the same vice versa. So you knew there was a child, a wife. So basically, you knew that you were going to be a homewrecker. And then I reached out to my sources to tell me about the wife and the child. And yo, I'm looking at Sheila like, girl, you done messed up this time. Everybody has nothing but good things to say about his wife. She is adorable, she is likable, and she's watching this whole saga of you, of him frolicking with a young girl. Like, she's watching it. She's looking at it like, whoa, wow, nice, Kongs boo boo. But when you're done, can you bring your ass home? Because we have to get this together. Which leaves the question, Sheila. So what happens? Because there are two things going to happen. Bainoku siba bao. Mubi. muyaye mufere mbidemu mubi muyaye mufere mubi muyaye mufere first of all eso katinga tuchita dao baino musiba kubaba munonya bamuli bize sawa yona bagenda mukwata echo kubiri we bamusiba is going to do a lot of time and when he come out I don't think your scrawny ass is going to be waiting for this man for you to be throwing yourself at his mercy like this what is it chichicho ze yakubaze zikumenya chimanyo oli mubazi ata wanobala for I know what Like, I'm still trying to suss this out. And in your long post, you are there lying to them. By here, he looked for me. Yeah, yeah, I know what ugambi feba gossipers. Tuligasia na emu nange. This is my job. Let me gossip. I am going to get paid. You're like, he's the one who stepped up to me. Sheila, I need for you to sit down and calm down, right? Because we all know the night that you met him. We all know what happened the night that you met him. We all know how you positioned yourself. We all know. Come on now. Umayi mgena ni mwandi kebi ntuku social. Ni mwela bida ate waliwa baba manjine in real life. Atenga na baba koye. So, calm down, you know. And let me tell you something. Now, this is coming. This is bagamba. Eriso liyomkulu awadugala wewalaba. Girlfriend, you are too young. Not that you were not of age, you are of age. Shit, you could be 29. And I'll still tell you, you are too young. Now, just because you've had way too much dick, don't give you age. No, we do not calculate your age according to how many men you've slept with. We're going to calculate it by real time, right? You are too young to be throwing yourself at a man like this before love. This is too soon. Too quick for you to begin thinking you're Bonnie and Clyde. This is just not the time. You still have like about 70 others of him to pass through. So kakana. Because, but me, before I even get any further into this, Banai, please appraise us of the situation when he leaves your ass. Yes, come back to social, type a very long post. And let us the Facebook inbox, like the in-laws, we are here to delve. Man, this girl, every time I think these girls are smarter, every time I think these girls have an edge, every time I think that these girls have seen better and know better, you always prove me right. Y'all is bimbos. You're stupid. Chikulumachi, Sheila. Chikujakochi. If you do not, kwete kamobutara. Omsajoredo chimanyi mubi, muyayi. Neno mwanika kubuli social media platform because you're trying to send a message to girls. And who told you that he is our dream boyfriend? You by here, all of you are here saying all these things about my man. But it's because most of you heifers out here, this is your dream man. That man. I'm sorry, I was raised with better standards. I was raised with way better standards. All the girls out there that were saying the same thing were raised with value, morals, and they knew their worth. They never ever want your man. We don't need your man. But me, Sheila. I am wasting so much energy on something that is going to die down. I'll be here to report when he breaks your heart. No, you don't have a heart. Maybe if he takes your bag. Because that's what you came to do, Sheila. Don't make this shit act out like you're in love. We know the stories. We've had them. We've sat with the people who played parts in those stories. You ain't here for love. So don't even. You don't love this man. But it's your bag, it's your business. We'll let you at it. Just let us know when it's over so that it can be our business again. That's simple. Oh, Sheila. And you see, Sheila Geshumba is like the poster child for TV stars. Just like Lindsay Lohan is the poster child for TV stars in Hollywood, I think Sheila Geshumba is the poster child for TV stars in Uganda. Because she started from here, now she's here. Goes without saying, parents, raise your kids. Stop raising them through maids, through school, no. Sit down and teach your kids real life morals. Sit down and have real life conversations. Sit down and tell your kids when they're going to be up where gombang and your baby. Bikutu samu situations. Sit down with your kids. Have conversations. Raise them right. Because when you raise them right, you'll be shocked the legacies they will leave behind for you. I'm going to sit back and watch this unfold. It's going to be fun. But again, I think this episode of Woman Crush Wednesdays is definitely going to be Love Sucks Wednesdays. So, you all know Joel Isabi. Nzabana njagala kumanya. Ani ya logo musajono. Bane wabanga gwe ya kwata akati ya kalogo musajono. Vayo, kakwetonde, kakusasule zaino kusasula. Because this is unfair. This is unfair. How can you always be the guy who breaks up before you get to even dakwajula? Gwani? This guy has been through so many women. I am confused at times. I can't keep track. So letters coming in is that he and Natty, his girlfriend or fiance, should I say, have broken up. Now Natty was who? Nimrod's journey. She left Nimrod ngamanyeno wali ya makulu. Never. I just found out today that he dated Rita Kagwatu. I'm like, yo, what? Snap. This guy has had, in the past decade, the women that I managed to count have been 10. But one thing is good on you, though. I'm making a sure one majana chalo officially. Na yete muli tuka kukwa anjula obe mbaga. Joel, ania kuloga. Gendo teke ngalo mubigali. Genda unonye Yezu. Gendo olinyoru sozi. You need intervention. What is wrong with you? That is what I was telling myself the whole time. Until I reached out to one of, it wasn't one, there were like three or four other channels he has been with and lived with. And they're like, Omanyi, tina ya? Waliwa abandu. Ngane wogeza kotia. Chiganya. I'm like, what do you mean? They're like, man, bozi za yo guided sola na zinyo miainaga yisaga vundu. Apparently, you're very ill-mannered, you're hot-tempered, you're all these things. And I'm like, nah, that can't be reasoning. How bad do you have to be for almost 10 viable, 10 women who could make good wives to leave you? And what's weird, though, is that when he leaves the girl, the wife, or the fiancé, when he breaks up with them, they get into real marriages. So I'm trying to understand. Gwasadaka ye chikacho. Mbutoli wasa, chichi, what's going on? That's my time for today. I think today I was just ranting. I think I was actually not ranting, I was trying to figure it out. All of it out. I'm still trying to figure it out. At TinaFierce1 is my Twitter handle, and on Facebook we are Scoop and Scoop and at TinaFierce1. Like, follow the pages on Instagram. It's at TinaFierce1 with an H on the Tina. Someone asked me, why do you say with an H? Yes, Tina has an H. I'm out. I'll catch you tomorrow, Thursday, where we're going to be reviewing some crazy, crazy, crazy new videos. My boy Mugaba just dropped his new song, Controller. I'm pumped. I'm psyched. I want to see it because the director of the video happened to be a co-worker at some point. So I'm pumped. We'll get into that tomorrow. I'm out. Peace.